is upon us as forging through an Antarctic winter. This time of year, the continent is sunk into a perpetual midnight, but the sweet, bright stars and silvery full moon offer plenty of light, especially when accompanied by the swirling electric tides of the auroral streets.
Jason, it's so bright to see you.
Stella hugged him. Grace lingered a little longer than expected, but he wasn't complaining.
I've got so much to show you, to tell you.
She started to lead him toward the station, but he kept his place. I've been reading the reports, he said, smiling. You do have a lot on your hands. Opening select sections of Pulse Cape, this protected biospheres must be a sensitive endeavor. I kept promising you some experience to help, so I'm here finally delivering on that in person. Jason waved to the rear compartment in the auto. The hatch opened, and two people climbed out and no more and parked it. The woman tucked a long tail of curly black hair, shot through with a few strands of gray and patch. She was helped out by a taller man, perfectly built, whose age most people would like their gear, but well worn together and inseparable. Jason introduced them. My mother, Ashley Carter, and stepdad, Benjamin Breslin. Stella shook their hands, surprised, smiled, thinking they looked even more beautiful.
It's great to meet you both. Come inside.
We can get you all warm. She led them all toward the back door station, the new entrance to the subterranean world below. As she turned away, Ben hung back and nudged Jason in the side with an elbow.
Nice, mate,
Ben said, his Aussie accent turning a little richer and what was there teasing him.
Now I see why you wanted to come and introduce us in passing. Can yourself a little Sheila.
Both women glanced back at him. Jason lowered his head, shaking it a bit. Ben scooted up between the others and took both Ashley and Stella under his arms.
Say, Kit tells me you found an interesting cavern system under the ice.
Do you know much about caves?
Stella asked. Stepfather was actually an expert cave with decades of experience. Most of it right here on this continent.
Well, I doubt you've seen anything like what we found down here,
Stella said proudly. You'd be surprised how much we have seen, his mother said with a grin. Someday, we'll have to invite you back to our place. Ben nodded.
What be an adventuring there for all of us? He glanced back to Jason. What do you say? Out for some fun?
Jason hurried to keep up with him.
Why did I think this was such a good idea?
8:23 p.m., Roanoke, Virginia. Kendall Hess drove the rental car up the long, tree-lined entryway to the private mental health facility. Rolling manicured lawns spread to garden parkways and small fountains. The building itself was divided into four wings, branching out like a cross in the center of these highly secured grounds. The hospital wasn't on any directory, and few knew of these 40 acres that bordered the Blue Ridge Parkway outside of Roanoke, Virginia.